In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate a custom blinking cursor easily with just one expression. Okay, maybe two. Hey guys, my name is Manuel. Alright, step one. Let's animate a simple typewriter, quickly adding the comp to the comp folder. We grab the title tool and add our text. Typewriter. Choose whichever font you want, it doesn't really matter. Just make sure to check in the paragraph tool that the text is aligned to the left. Then we add a scale animator. Here in the drop-down menu, set scale to 0. We open the range selector and animate the start point with 2 keyframes. 0 at the beginning, 100% after 1 second. The letters are smoothly scaling up, which we don't want. Way too smooth in this case. So we set the smoothness to 0. And let's add EasyEase in to both keyframes, which adds some smoothness again, but to the overall animation speed, as you can see here in the graph editor. So how do we add a cursor to that? The great thing is the width of the text layer adjusts depending on the number of letters. The plan is to attach the cursor to the right edge of the text layer with an expression. Let's use another object for that. We name it position cursor. Next, we go to Effect, Expression Controls, and add a layer control. We use the layer control to tell the null object where to get the data from, which is the text layer, of course. In order to determine the position of the right edge of the layer, we need to know the width of the layer. Therefore, we use a slider control, which we add to the null object as well. Let's name it width. What if there's a place for everything you need to create stunning videos? MotionArray.com has video footage, music, sound effects, templates, and plugins for After Effects and Premiere Pro, which is awesome because it saves you a lot of time and money. It's one subscription for all. Pay once, use it as much as you want. Subscribe through the link in the description and get $50 off. MotionArray.com. Now let's get to the actual expression. We add an expression to the slider property. First of all, we establish a variable. W, like width, equals get your data from this layer. We link to the layer control. Semicolon. And in the next line, we specify which data exactly. Square brackets, and inside, W dot. Source rectat time, here it is, meaning at the current time, get what? The width of the text layer. Dot width. You can see the slider control gets the width value of the text layer at the current time. So to get the cursor position, we start here at the left edge, where the anchor point of the text layer is. Which also means that's the position of the text layer. So we link the position of the null to the position of the text layer. Then we simply need to add the width to get to the right edge. We open the expression and add plus, then simply add the width by linking it to the slider control. And the null object moves along. Awesome! Next, we simply add a shape or whatever you want to use as cursor, position it, name it cursor probably, and link it to the null object. Awesome, that's it. If we want the cursor to blink, we simply split the layer after the text is revealed and set the opacity to 0. Set a keyframe, 20 frames later we set it to 100, then back to 0. We turn the keyframes into toggle hold keyframes. Then we add an expression to the opacity, which is the second expression, and add a loop out expression. If it blinks too slow, we simply move the keyframes closer together. By the way, if you want to change the timing, move the keyframes, not the layers itself, because that will mess up the expressions. Make sure to check out the links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.